The Philippine Immigration Bureau is saying goodbye to paper-based departure cards. The agency says it will expand the so-called e-travel system to lessen the requirements for passengers. That means travelers no longer have to fill out departure cards. Instead, they just have to log in to the online portal prior to their flight. The use of paper-based cards will end on April 30, but travelers can start using the e-travel website by April 15. Departing passengers may log in to the platform 72 hours before their flight or not later than 3 hours prior. Transport authorities ready for the expected exodus this coming Holy Week break. Let's now get the latest on the situation at the Parañaque Integrated Terminal Exchange. Our correspondent Jose Carretero joins us on the line. Jose, good afternoon. How is it going there now?
Good afternoon, Rica. Passengers continue to arrive at the Parañaque Integrated Terminal Exchange, or PITX. As of 9 a.m., the PITX management has reported 24,267 passengers. Yesterday, the terminal recorded 94,541 passengers. Most of the passengers, Rica, at PITX are heading to the Bicol region, Visayas, and Mindanao. However, many bus trips to various places in Bicol for Holy Week next week are already fully booked. Most of the air-conditioned bus lines going to the Bicol region are fully booked starting today until April 6. Some bus lines have yet to announce the availability of their special trips, but there are already buses with special trips that have deployed extra buses to accommodate chance passengers. Non-air-conditioned buses with trips going to Bicol, Visayas, and Mindanao, however, are not fully booked, but they expect more influx of passengers starting next week. Meanwhile, NCRPO Chief Police Major General Edgar Alan Acobo inspected the terminal this morning to check the situation. He said the number of passengers still manageable, but they are expecting an influx of passengers starting Monday. General Acobo said around 130,000 to 150,000 passengers are expected to arrive here next week. Additional police force has been deployed to transport hubs in Metro Manila, according to General Acobo. He adds that no untoward incident has been recorded so far, but he warns passengers to be extra careful and secure their belongings. Passengers are also urged to travel light.
Naiintindihan natin na gusto nila magdibit-bit ng pasalubong dahil nakaulgalian yan. Pero baka pwedeng this time mag-travel light tayo para sa dalawang bagay. Unang-una, para hindi tayo mahirapan. And then pangalawa, para mabigyan din natin yung mga ibang kapamilya natin makapagbit-bit din ng kanilang pasalubong.
Meanwhile, Rica, LTO Chief J.R. Tugade inspected the terminal around 11 this morning. This is to check the roadworthiness of buses, especially those with long trips. A bus going to Bulan Sorsogon was not allowed to travel due to expired franchise. The reverse light of the bus was also defective, while the left tire was already worn out. Rescue bus has already been requested to avoid delay of passengers. LTO says they will continue the inspection until next week to ensure safety of passengers. Rica.
Hi, Jose. Just one question, please. Can you confirm the online booking status of the bus line? Are they all fully booked? What for those going to the terminals to physically go in line for ticket purchase?
Actually, Rica, passengers can check the social media accounts of bus company. Some passengers say they post update on their social media accounts. Rica.
All right. With that, I will let you go. Jose Carretero, reporting live. Thank you for the time. Meanwhile, the Philippine Ports Authority says it is now on heightened alert ahead of the Holy Week break. It has also partnered with the Maritime Industry Authority and the Philippine Coast Guard to ensure the safety of ship passengers.
Yung ating mga port security personnel, lahat po ng mga operations personnel natin sa 130 terminals natin nationwide, kanselado po lahat ng leave nila simula April 3 hanggang April 10. To make sure na full power complement tayo 24/7 sa lahat ng terminals natin.
Over now to the Luzon Expressways, traffic enforcers will be deployed in strategic areas of the South Luzon Expressway during the Holy Week break. Its operator says motorists can avail of free towing from Wednesday to Monday. Faulty or damaged auto sweep cards will also be replaced for free.
Inaasahan din namin itong Semana Santa, mag-i-increase na naman ng mga 10% from that 40%, no? So, magbawon ho yung mga motorista natin na maraming pasensya ho kasi marami talagang biyahe.
Meanwhile, traffic remains light at the North Luzon Expressway, but the management says an increase in the volume of cars is expected by Wednesday. They also advised motorists to prepare ahead to avoid hassles.
Pinapanawagan po natin sa ating mga motorista na magbibiyahe, lalong-lalo na po yung papuntang norte, na kung hanggat maaari ay magpakabit na po ng RFID kung wala pa po sila. At kung sila naman po ay may RFID na, mainam po na i-check nila at ma-ensure na meron po silang sapat na load, kasi minsan yun pa yung nagkakos din ng traffic sa ating mga RFID lanes naman po.
The European Commission will continue to recognize certificates of seafarers issued by the Philippines. In a statement posted on its website, the Commission acknowledged Manila's efforts to improve the training of Filipino sailors. In December 2021, the Commission warned Filipino seafarers would be banned from working in the regional bloc's jurisdiction unless serious measures were taken to address compliance to international standards. That put in jeopardy the jobs of some 50,000 Filipinos. Crisis averted. That's how Migrant Workers Secretary Susan Tuts Ople described the EU's move to recognize the certificates of Filipino seafarers. In a statement released Saturday, Ople said, "This development is a testimony to the leadership and political will of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. in ensuring the country's compliance with the European Commission's standards." Ople also thanked the European Commission for recognizing Manila's efforts to improve the country's seafarers' education. The owner of the ship that caught fire off the coast of Basilan, killing 29 people, apologizes for the tragic incident. In a statement, Allison Shipping Lines expressed its condolences to the families of those who died. It assured the public it is cooperating with authorities in investigating the real cause of the fire. The company added it has given out financial assistance to those affected. The MV Lady Mary Joy 3, carrying some 200 passengers, was on its way to Sulu from Zamboanga when it caught fire off Balok-Balok Island in Basilan Wednesday night. Around 22 people remain missing. The Philippine Coast Guard said some of those who died of drowning did not have life vests. In other news, agriculture group SINAG believes a pork shortage this month is unlikely. The Philippine Agriculture Department had warned of a shortage in the supply of pork this month due to the African swine fever. It added that by June, there will be a shortage of at least 46,000 metric tons of pork. But SINAG President Rosendo So says that won't happen because of the abundance of imported pork. He, however, urges the government to implement stricter measures in the importation of meat products amid the threat of ASF.
Yung imported na pumapasok dito sa ating bansa. Up to now, Henry, wala pang testing. Ibig sabihin, ito mga produkto na pumapasok from other countries, wala nang pagsuri pagdating dito sa ating bansa. So yung outbreak ng ASF, outbreak ng bird flu, kaya continuous